Before the meter or the inch, people were using their own bodies to measure lengths. The ancient Egyptians used the cubit, the length of the forearm from the elbow to the tip of the middle finger. And the Greeks used the lick to measure just the distance from the tip of the thumb to the tip of the index finger. Well, more recently, people started using a folding ruler. But as you know, it takes time to open. You need a specially dedicated pocket for it, and those joints get loosened up after some time, which makes your work absolutely inefficient. Length is one of the most important and fundamental measurements. Long time ago, units of length were not standardized and you could find different units in different regions. So, as you can imagine, there was a huge mess. Fortunately today, we have a simple device that is easy to use and can be very accurate if you know how to use it. And this one is, of course, the measuring tape. The history of the imperial units is very interesting. However, after France adopted the metric system in 1799, it spread all over the world and became the unit of choice. With the decimal system and the standardization of the meter, we can make very accurate measurements. The meter in Greek literally means to measure and is defined by the SI unit system as the length of the path traveled by light in a vacuum in 1/299,792,458 seconds. Well, speaking of which, check our video about LDMs. Measure the distance with the speed of light. Of course, not all countries like the US or the UK use the metric system, and this makes a mess with the unit conversion or problems reading correctly the length. So, let's see how we can improve our measurements with the measuring tape. If you have a measuring tape that uses inches, you better know your fractions, because 1 inch has 16 parts and there is no such thing as 14/16 of an inch. On the other hand, the meter uses decimal system and the measuring tape is usually accurate down to a millimeter. Well, most of the measuring tapes have a hook at the end, and at first glance it seems that it's broken, but it's not, it's a feature. Depending on how you take the measurement, if you pull the tape or push it in, it compensates the width of the hook. Another thing that will make your life much easier is knowing the length of the base of the measuring tape, well, which is specified right here. This will allow you to go right to the corner with the tape and add the length of the tape to the measurement without breaking the tape and looking at it in a weird position. Well, as you can see, eventually you will have to break it, or you will have to take a measurement at a certain height. This is where the concave shape of the tape comes for the rescue. If the tape was flat, it would break. However, the concave shape and the 25mm width of the tape hold it straight, even at some level above the ground. There are two types of tapes. Spring return one is like this, and it has a special mechanism that allows you to stop and hold the tape at one point, and usually it ranges up to 8 meters. So, you can easily put it into your pocket. You can also find longer ones that go as long as 20 meters. But for longer distances, it is advised and safer to use the long measuring tape. Just imagine that your friend has just left the other side and the tape is flying back to you like a rocket. Speaking of holding the other side of the tape, if you are forever alone, in some tapes you can use a nail to hold a hook with this little hole. With the same method, you can also draw a circle, just define the radius, stick a nail on one side and pencil to the other. In more advanced tapes, you can find other markings and not just meters and centimeters. For example, if the tape was certified, you can find the class rating 1, 2 or 3. The higher the number, the less accurate it is. But you can also find other marks that specify some of the most common lengths. There are some features that you should check before buying a measuring tape. If you are going to use both imperial and metric units, check if the tape has both. Some of the tapes have an additional coating layer like nylon, so it won't wear out easily. Other useful features include magnetic hook, a belt clip, and markings on both sides of the tape. If you have other tips or tricks on how to use the tape, share them with us. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video. And remember, measure twice, but cut once. Like it or not, make sure you subscribe. The next are coming. If you need more information, read the description below and have fun.